Hi all, welcome back to Loadrunner Advanced Training Sessions. Today we will be discussing about file operations, how to open the file, how to read and how to write the data into a file, and other topics which are related to file. So what are the functions are available for reading, writing, character wise. So those details we will be discussing today. Before going to that, I have a few things left for correlation that I will cover first, later I will move to next session. So let's say I want to get the entire response, server response. So what is the function we have to use? Okay, so webbridge save param, save underscore param param. So use the response body. Okay, now I am going to get the response body. So give lb as empty, rb as empty. So that's all you have to do. Nothing, just give empty left boundary, empty right boundary. Search equal to should be body. If you want body, give body. If you want headers, give headers. Last. If I run this now, I will get entire response body of this request. Okay, so I will keep on breakpoint here, or better I will keep letter after, yeah, at this request. Okay, so let's see. So this is the function. If you give left boundary, right boundary empty, it will capture the entire response body. Okay, so this is the way we should pass. Okay, it's taking some time. And yeah, let me stop this. Let me go to the script and take that value and search in the replay log. Okay, so if you see here, this is the response body. Okay, so you might be getting until this one. So it may have more response body. So as for this function, maximum you will get 256 bytes of data. Okay, so it may have lot of response still. If you want to get more response entire from starting to ending, you must use the function. By default, this function will save 250 characters of data. This function saves 256 characters of data or bytes of data. Okay, data. Okay, so to a file. By default this is the one. If you want to increase this size, we have to use one more function. That should be at after your declaration of variables, it should be the immediate function, web underscore set underscore max underscore html underscore param underscore length. So this is the function to increase the parameter length of the correlation function. So if I give 10,000 bytes, so it will get the entire response. I assume this response should be 10,000 bytes, so I am giving 10,000 as the length. So if I run now, I may be getting more than this response. Okay, so let's see one more time, will be getting or not. So this is very important function. Sometimes if you do correlation for view state event validation in .NET, that view state will be sometimes very big value. In order to capture that view state, if you use normal webbridge save param, it won't be capturing all the value. It might be saying failing, increase the value of parameter length in the error log, if you see, you may be seeing that value. Okay, use website max HTML param length to increase the length of your parameter. So that is the reason this is the very important function. If you want to capture very big response or very big correlation value from the server, then you must pass this value, otherwise your correlation will fail, saying I could not able to find the left boundary, because by default it will capture this many length. If the value is more than this length, and nowadays advanced function, advanced 9.5 correlation function, they increase the length to 1024 or something. So if it is more than that, definitely it will fail. So for that, not to fail this script at this correlation, you know that this is mandatory value. It has to come from the server, whatever length, then you must increase the value, so size of the parameter. So to increase the size of this length correlation, you must use website max HTML param length and give whatever you length you want. Max is I think 9,99,999 or something you can give. Okay, so now let's go and see the response body. This time it should be little big. Okay, so see, now it is coming little big. Okay, so that is the way we have to give. Okay, if your response is very big, you can give that one. Now let's say I want the header information, you have to pass headers so that it will capture the headers next time. So likewise, you can use either headers or body to capture. If you don't give anything, it will captures everything. So by default, the search will be all. First it will capture header, then it will start capturing body. So that is the way it will do. If you pass specifically some argument as such as body, it will captures only body. If you give such as headers, it will captures only header. See, HTTP 200 OK, and what is the date, and these are the header information. You can see that in the snapshot under replay log. If you go no response headers, so this is the response header value. Let me maximize. These are the values. Okay, all this information will be captured in the output window. Okay, so see, all the details were captured. So this way we can see even response also captured, because I have given the length also, so maximum length, so it has captured all the values. Okay, so this way we can capture the all the response headers and everything. Okay, so this is the two things I didn't cover in my earlier video, so that the reason I have covered here. So this is all about correlation. So if you give left, some interviews they may be asking, if I give left boundary, right boundary, what will happen? It always captures entire response. If you, the search equal to headers, it will capture header, entire header response. If the search equal to body, it will capture the entire body response. So if you want to increase the length of that parameter value, we must use the website max HTML param length function in order to capture the big correlation values, lengthy ones like one page, two page values. You must use this function. Okay, so these are the topics which were left in the correlation. So I completed. So let's move to file operations. Okay, so yeah, let me record one more script, because I don't want to do any mess up with these scripts. So okay, let me go to web HTML blank script. I will record only web part. Okay, so I will go to recording options and see which option I have used. So here it is HTML, so I will record only URL. So okay, I will record until URL loads. Later I will stop, because I just wanted that value, correlation of user session or something. I will show you how to write into a
notepad. Okay, any file. Okay, so there is some issue, it is not recording. Let me stop this. Yeah, anyway, it has recorded that URL what I wanted. So now what I will do is, now we will discuss about how to use file operations. So for file operations, in order to write into a file or read into a file, you must know the file path. Okay, where to write or read. Okay, so file path is mandatory, where to write your file or where to read from the file. So to, once you know the file path, you need one more variable called to read or write operations to perform on the file path. You must use one long variable, because the file length will be very long. So that is the reason you can't use int. Int maximum can support small lengthy values. If you want very big lengthy files, then use long. So I will use long as a file. Variable name is file I am using. So I need one variable which can hold the file path, so that it will use reading purpose and writing purpose. So only one thing you need is just use one long variable. That is the only one mandatory variable is required. To this one will be used for this variable is used to perform operations on file read or write. Okay, if you want to do some operations on file, you must use one variable. So this variable will be used mainly. Okay, now what I will do, file equal to, because the path, whatever file path I am opening, that will point to this file. Okay, so now fopen is the function to open the file. Okay, if event is not there, you can use write or you can use read, because automatically it will create the file. Now I am going to create the file. Let me check which folder I will create. So I am going to create the file in the F drive, okay, or E drive. Okay, I will keep E drive. I will remove this user session.txt, or I will use the different file. Okay, now I am, for now I am going to read my file, write or read. So use double quotations and the path, and I will give variable name user session 1.txt. So this is the file name which I am going to create. If it is not there, it will create the file. If it is there, it will use the same file name. Okay, that is the first you have to use file open function. File open function will open this file. If it is not there, it will create for you. If it is there, it will use that file. Okay, and what is the operations? There are many operations which you can perform: read or write, comma R plus means the file already existing. If the file is already there, you can use R plus directly, no need to create file. Okay, comma W plus if you want to append A, and if you want to append already existing file A plus. So likewise, we have many operations. So now, for now, I am going to use write. Okay, W. So write means W. So this is the two things. This is the path of the file where you want, where the your file is located, and this is which operation you want to perform. So there are two arguments you have to pass in the file open. One is path of your file location, the other one is which operation you want to perform, whether it is open file reading or file writing or whatever operation you want, you can perform here. So if you want more information, click on F1, you will get help, and you can get more information. See, one is file name, the path of your file, and this it returns long variable. So that is the reason I am holding that return value into a long variable. So the long will be always, the file will be long, right? Very. And what is the accessful mode? Access mode, whether it is a write, read, and all I mentioned, right? So this is the name of the file to open. That is what I explained just now. And this is the mode. R means writing, W means writing, A means append. What is A means? If already there is a some data is available in the file, if you don't want to remove that data, you just want to add some more data to that file, in that case you use A. Okay, R plus and W plus A plus, where plus signs indicate that the file must be already existing. If the file is already existing, you want to perform some operation on that existing file, you must use R plus. Okay, don't use R. If this normal R and WAR, if the file is not existing, it will create for you and it will perform those operations on that file. Okay, so this is all about FOpen. Okay, now once you open this file on write mode, it is ready to write the text into that file. Okay, now that the opening, closing, everything will be operated by file now onwards. Why means I saved this value into this file file variable. Now this open, closing, everything you have to do with file only. Okay, now let's say I have to do some correlation value. So in my previous video I explained you, right? I can use this one as empty so that it captures the value from this response. Now after it captures, after this request, what I have to do? So after this function, I have to write the value into a file. For that you can use fprintf or fwriteF. fprintf. Okay, so this is one function to write. Okay, and you have many things, many functions. You have write, okay, and f set, I think. So f set, okay, set one character. Okay, so there are many functions which we can write. Now let's go and see what is f f printf means. So this is writes formatted output to a file. Okay, it will write a formatted output to a file. Okay, formatted output means without any special characters, whatever it is, no. So only readable format. Okay, so that way we can use it. For now I will use fprintf to write to a file. Okay, later I will explain you remaining functions. So for now listen only fprintf, what it will do. Okay, let's go to example of fprintf, what it will do, you will get some idea. Okay, so first you, what you need is file. So the file pointer what you saved, right? File long.file, that is the file which you want to read or write. This is the text what you want to write, or you just give percentages. S means string, it can be numeric value, it can be special character, anything. Okay, and you pass that value, whatever correlation value you want to do, you can pass that value. Okay, so now first value is what is the file. Okay, so the file name is file. So I will go file comma, what is the format, that is strings. My correlation value is having strings, right? Means combination of characters. It might be variables, or it might be numerics, it might be characters, it might be special characters, anything. For that you need to use percentage s, strings. Okay, So I am passing this because this is correlation value. I can't pass directly here. For that is the reason I am converting that value into this understandable language. So that is the reason I have written LR eval string. That value is a string. It is holding string. That string will be written into this file because already the file is opened in write mode. So that is the reason it will directly write the value into a file. After writing, what you have to do? F close. So after writing is done, close the file. Okay. So you must close the file, otherwise always the file will be in open state only. It never closes until your system restarts. So these are the three minimum used functions you must know. One is long variable, fopen, and later onwards you no need to open every time. You can point that variable to a file variable. From there onwards you can use file pointer, okay, that long variable. And this is the percentage means if it is a string, you can use that way. Otherwise, if I want to pass something like, no, I have one more variable int I equal to 200 or 2000. Okay. Now, if I want to save this value, I have to use here one more file, print. I will show you this one. Once I am done with this one, later I will show you how to store the integer value. Okay. So for now we will see whether the value will be stored in the file or not. Okay. So for that, let me run the script now. Okay. So yeah, I am running the script. So now it is opened and now it is closed. So now I can go to F drive and I can E drive, right? So now I can go to E drive and I can see the file user session.1. So we can see here the file name is user session 1. So that is the file is appearing here, user session 1, and the value is stored as headers. All the header information is stored here. And so you might be thinking whether it is correct or not. So we can check that value here also. Okay, I don't have now to show. Okay, so let me open F4 and I will give data written by the server. We will come to know whether that is correct or not. If I go to logs, and enable logs parameter substitution, if I do, so it will be, you can match now. Okay, so whether it is written same value or not. So before doing any activity you must close that file. See, otherwise no, it won't read. Already it says it's already open. So now I close that value. Now I will rerun the script. So now we can go and verify whether the data is correct or not. Okay. So now the response body, whatever you got from the correlation, this entire value will be saved into a file. That is this one. So 141, right? So I can go and verify here also it is correct or not. So I can go to output log and you can see here, see 01404 also you can see here. Okay, so it has written all the data, and also you can see the date also when it has written 631. So now the time is 632. So that way we can verify whether the data has been written into the file or not. Okay, so this way you have to use fprintf to write the data into a file, formatted data. If whenever you do correlation, the best function you have to use is fprintf. Okay, and you can close that function. Okay, so now I will comment this function. For now I will use one more fprintf to read write the integer variable data, int data. Now I have written string data, right? Now we will see how to write this data. Okay, percentage d, we have to use percentage d, d for digits, and use i is the variable. So now the i is holding 2000, right? Now the i is holding 2000 value. That value will be returned to the this file function. That file is this one, user session 1.txt. Now whatever data is there here, it will be cleared and the new value will be entered, because I am not appending the data here, I am overriding my data. Whatever data is there in that file, it will remove and it will insert the new data. If I run now, we can see 2000 in my file. Okay, so let it run. Yeah, now it is passed. And if I go to this one, now I can see only 2000. Okay, likewise you can write whatever data you want. If you want integer, declare some integer data, that data will be written to a file. You have to use a printf function and use that variable here, and you must mention this one as the d. For d as the digits, in C, percentage d, percentage t, c is for characters, percentage s for strings, likewise you will be using, right? The same way you have to use, d means digits, s means strings. Okay, so file is the variable where you can do operations, right? Writing, reading. So this is all about file, how to write the file into a file, how to create the file, which mode you want to create, whether it is a write mode or read mode. Or now I will show you one more thing. Okay, now I don't want to erase my data, every time it has to be appended. Okay, so now I can give a plus, because already my file is existed in my location, so I no need to create every time. So I just wanted to append every time 2000 2000. So if I run for three times, the 2000 will be copied. Okay, so I will go to run logic and let me run for 5 times. Now the file, make sure the file is closed. Yeah, it is closed. Now if I run now, the value won't be erased every time, it will just append the data to existing file. Whatever data is there in your file, it won't remove, it will keep on adding your data into a file. Okay, so we'll see now. I think 5 times or 6 times, because already first time there is a 2000, right? So now 6 times you must see the 2000 value here. See, first time already there. Now I have ran 5 times, 1 2 3 4 5 times, the data is written without erasing. If you don't give append, what it does is it will remove the existing data. If I give only w, it will remove existing data and it will place only recent data. If I run now 5 times, you can see only 1 time, because every time it will remove old data and it will keeps new data. So that is the where we have to take the special care, whether you want to override the data, whether you want to read the data. Okay, so this is very important topic. You must use that append or w with care. Okay, so now if I go here, the value will be 2000. See, every time the value keeps on removing, and finally final time whatever value will be there, it will be available in the file. Okay, so this is all about file operations. As a simple way, you must use 3 functions. One you need is variable, and one is file open, and path, and which mode of writing or reading or appending, and copy that file in f open into a file, and use fprintf, and use f close for closing. So this is very simple methodology you can use for file writing. So thanks for watching. See you in next session. In next session I will be discussing about how to read the data from the file. Okay, so please subscribe, do let others know. Thank you. Please like the videos if you like. Thanks for watching. See you in next session. Bye for now.